Hi, this is Will Hillenbrand. I'm going to tell you about how I made the artwork for 1230 O'Leary. Now, just so that you know, before you start looking too far in depth, I'm not going to be able to go into detail about all the pictures and slides that you're going to be seeing. Some of this you'll just have to pick up on your own and see the transitions between the pages. But I used film in making this book and, of course, drawing. And here's a piece of film I'm pulling away that I've cut into place. I'll use little artifacts of that to overlap and make a little bit denser color for the floor. This page that you're looking at will end up being used for the front cover. So I've used colored pencil to create some darker values, film to make the background of the bed. Here I'm making some dark green spots, more like stains on this crazy chest, the back of the bottom of the bed that seems to come to life. I use some ink and paper towel to make the color on film. I'll place it on the art and then I'll trim away what I don't need. More pencil drawing to add value. The pieces I'm putting over top are transparent. They've got a wax base to them, so I can overlap them, then trim them out. In some cases, I'll flip the paper over the artwork, and I'll add a little bit darker color to the back side. Here you can see I'm adding a little bit of a shadow beneath the pillow. In this case, I used some acrylic paint on the acetate and did some finger painting. I'm going to use that finger painting once it's dried. I'll cut out a piece. In this case, I put it on top of the cap, and then I'll put a part of it over the body, and then I'll trim away the parts I don't need and pull that away. Using colored pencil, I'll make the striped pattern for the pillow, adding more in this case, a purple to the bedspread texture, highlighting that with a little bit of blue. Going all across the page. I put a light purple film on top of the bed for that cover, and then, of course, used a swivel X-Acto knife to cut away what I don't need. You know, pulling away a little piece of that over the pillow. More of the same here. The pattern on the bed will be made of kind of a checkerboard pattern, so I'm cutting out that. So when I overlap these pieces, you see a little bit more darker value for like a checkerboard pattern on the bedspread. And you can see more of the page here. It's beginning to develop now all across the page. There's both the front and back side, so you can see what I still need to do. Made the wood pattern for the back post of the bed. Now I'm going to focus on the figures I haven't done yet and figure out which colors I want to use. Blue here, it looks like, for the boy. Done the pencil drawing. I'm going to put the film on top and trim it away. And you can see I pulled it away, now working on the girl in the red pajamas. And then the extra part I'm pulling away here. I'll burnish it down. So there, sometimes it gets to be little bubbles underneath the film, so I want to burnish that out so it's nice and flat. So that's what I did there, piecing together the background for the bed. In this case, I think I did a separate face. I wasn't sure I was happy with the face that was on the artwork originally, so I cut out and drew another face, and I put it in position, but I don't think you can tell that I did that. I hope you can't tell. Now you know, because you've seen it, though. Some red flaming hair, purple pajamas. That's where I work on my desk when I'm making page. Let's see, the checkerboard pattern was drawn here. And the purple is added to this little girl. Both the pages on both sides, front and back cover, are completed. I'll put that in my dry mount press and actually glue it to a stiffer board. And after that's finished and the piece is ready to be sent to the publisher, it looks like this. I hope you enjoy reading the book 1230 O'Leary, and I hope you also enjoyed the process.